Have a close look at the search results on YouTube. You see in the corner here, we have a filter. When we open it, we see that all videos are sorted by relevance. So obviously, relevance is an important factor to rank your videos on YouTube. And to give you the full picture, the YouTube ranking factors are relevance and low competition to make your video start ranking and to keep your video ranking. That means not only ranking in the first few days, but also for months and years to come. There we have click-through rate and average view duration as the other two most important ranking factors. We already know that click-through rate is important. We design our thumbnails to be clicky, so this way we increase our click-through rate. And also average view duration, of course, is a no-brainer. We try to create our videos in a way that people watch to the end. So that's clear. But how about relevance and low competition? Low competition, more about that later. Let's talk about relevance today. We need high relevance in order to even have a chance to rank our videos. Without it, it isn't possible because, as we saw, videos are sorted by relevance. And if you have low relevance, then you always will be at very bottom, nowhere to be seen, right? And since relevance is all about how the search terms that viewers type into the search bar matches your video metadata, let me explain you today how to optimize your metadata for optimal relevance and how this is calculated. By the way, calculated, there is no official definition from YouTube how relevance is actually measured. But from years of experience, best practices and all that, hints in the Creator Academy articles and so on, we know pretty sure how relevance is calculated. And that is what I will go into detail today. To give you an intuitive understanding of it, let's look at the Morningfame keyword research tool just because it looks more intuitive there. We have typed in the how to rank keywords on YouTube search term. So we see here these videos rank in the search results and these yellow markings you see here. Those depict visually how relevant the video is. So what we can see here, keywords on YouTube, this is part of the search term, keywords on YouTube. You see it in the search term as well. This matches. Yeah, everything that is in yellow here is somehow matching the search term that the viewer typed into the search bar. Here, my video as well, how to rank on YouTube, is part of the title. We have how to rank on YouTube here as well. Since we don't see so many yellow markings here, also the relevance is not quite high. This video is 54% relevant. My video is only 53% relevance. So of course, the goal is to get the relevance as high as possible. But it always depends on which search term you look at, which search term the viewer types into the search bar in order to find your videos in the search results, right? So here, for example, we typed in how to rank for a competitive keyword, right? This is the search term. My video appears in spot number 2 here with 57% relevance. That is the relevance for this search term. When we look at the previous search term, yeah, same video here, same metadata. For this search term, the relevance was lower, 53%. So understand that the relevance always is attached to the search term that you want to optimize for. The search term has to have low competition and all that, how you choose it, later on that more. But let's say we have a given search term we want to optimize for. And for that, we want to increase the relevance ideally to 100%, right? Here I have a search term, YouTube SEO checklist, where one of my video ranks. And this video has a 95% relevance. That is where we want to go with optimizing our videos, in the 90% plus range. And you can see it clearly here as well. We have the search term in the title exactly like it is. Nothing else. That's the best what you can do, by the way. We have YouTube SEO checklist in the description as well. And that is continued with the tags. We have the same search term here as well, related YouTube SEO cheat sheet and so on. So this is the way I optimized it up to a 95% relevance. But of course, let's go through it in more detail. Here in the number 4 optimize tab of the Morningfame keyword research tool. By the way, did I mention before that there is an invite to the tool to test it out for free if you want to? But anyway, this will give you a good understanding that you could even do it without a tool. So in Morningfame, in the number 4 optimize tab, you optimize your metadata to have a high relevance score, 95% in this case, for the search term that you chose, video description, YouTube in this case. So I have highly optimized metadata finished here for you to explain. Let's start with the title. I achieved 36% out of 40% that go into the total relevance score because I have this search term we optimize around in the title in the beginning as well. I added something in the end. Let's remove it real quick. You see, now it went up to 40%. The total score went up to 99% even, because in terms of relevance, the best thing that you can do is have the search term that viewer type into the search bar in order to find your video, have that search term in your title like it is, no change, exactly like this, no additions and so on. But if you want to add something extra, let's add it here again, then ideally put it at the end. This only gives you a 4% loss. If I would use this part and put it in the beginning, real quick, you see 32% only. Yeah, so you get more loss if you add something in the beginning of your title. Don't do that. Always have your search term first and any additions at the end. So let's quickly reword it. You see, by the way, I have this full score here, but always Morningfame gives you tips. And here it actually explains you that it is a good idea to add something in the end. Although you lose a little bit of relevance, you want that in order to get a higher click-through. The idea here is that I have something added for the viewer to read where your SEO shines, which makes the viewer more likely to click. We already know that our thumbnails are the most important part where we can increase the click-through. That means that more people who see your video will actually click it and watch it. But also the title can play its role by having something intriguing written at the end. By the way, I have a video on my channel here which explains you this title strategy in much more detail. It really is the perfect balance between relevance and click-through rate that we also need in order to keep our videos ranking for a long time. Let's move on to the description. Here you can see again that I have 20 out of 20% achieved for the total score. And that is because I included the target search term, which you can see here highlighted in the description text as well, which is part of a human readable text, of course. And by the way, you can even go further and include more search terms that you see underlined here. But to explain you this powerful technique in more detail, check out this video. Let's move on. For relevance, we have achieved here the maximum. Tags as well, 39% out of 40% going into the total score. That means I included the target search term as a tag as well, which gives me 11%. Going into the 39%, going into the total score. Now, basically, it's all a sum of optimized aspects that you have in the metadata adding up to your total relevance score. And then related tags like video description box on YouTube, and so on. So all that here in yellow, those add to the total score, which makes it a highly optimized video in this case. Of course, knowing how Morningfame calculates the relevance score is one thing. You probably wonder how to optimize your tags, which one to choose. I recently made a video that explains you in a lot of detail how I pick the particular tags, how I compile the whole tag list. So check it out. And by the way, title, description, and tags is not the only metadata that you have on your video. Let's move on. We also have a pinned comment section here, which is, by the way, nothing about relevance, but it's important to mention because here you have the chance with your pinned comment to recommend your viewers to watch another of your videos on your channel. And this is your foot in the door to not only rank your videos in search, but also to get your videos recommended in the suggested videos, for example. This is truly powerful. This goes so much beyond relevance. So if you want to learn more about that, well then check out this live stream I did recently with Daniel Bartal, which really explains to you a whole strategy about how to get into suggested videos with these techniques. And moving forward, we also have a thumbnail comparison section. Here I uploaded my own thumbnail and see the other thumbnails of videos ranking for the same search term. This helps me to understand whether my thumbnail pops enough so that people rather click on my video rather than the other videos that already rank for this search term. I mean, in the beginning we learned, right? To keep your video ranking for a long time, we need click-through rate, where the thumbnail is the most important part. So that is the reason why you see a thumbnail section that helps you to improve the thumbnails here even further. But let's go back to the relevance score in detail. I said in the beginning, this is added from tags, the percentage, description, the percentage, and the title, the percentage. So we have 95%. But is that enough? Yeah, we always try to optimize our videos so that they come close to 100% relevance, but it's not always enough to rank your videos in terms of relevance. The big goal here is to set your video apart from the other videos that already rank for the search term you want to rank as well. So you can see here already, the average relevance of videos ranking for the search term is 44%. With my 95% relevance, I set myself quite a lot apart from the average video ranking for the search term. This difference between average and my own relevance, that is how Morningfame calculates the grade. And since I'm setting myself apart so much, I get an A grade, the best possible grade that I can get on Morningfame. But getting an A grade is not always possible, actually. If we look at this search term, for example, how to rank on YouTube, well, then we see the relevance grade here is only a C. What you see here is the potential grade that you can get with 100% relevance. The reason why it's only showing a C grade is here because the average, yeah, is 64% relevance. Yeah, when we scroll down, all the videos 53, 68, 67, 78, all those videos are highly optimized as well. So the average is quite high. And with a potential of 100% relevance score, you can only set yourself apart a little bit, yeah, not too much. And that is the reason why you get a C grade here with perfect metadata only. And for Morningfame users, by the way, the recommendation is to get at least a B grade here. So you set yourself apart from the already ranking videos, set yourself apart enough. But of course, we see here, we not only get a grade for relevance, we also get three other grades for subscribers, views, likes, and comments, right? And these grades are there for a reason, because these other three grades tell you how competitive a search term is. And that is really important. Again, the YouTube ranking factors to start ranking your videos is not only relevance, but also low competition. So what you need to do in order to rank your videos high on YouTube is to get relevance as well as the competition right. This will make your videos start ranking after you publish it. So that is the reason why we have the four grades. Relevance for relevance, obviously, and the other three grades for the competition. And having the video now, understanding relevance really good, Well, now is the question how you get low competition. And for that, I have a really great video here that teaches you many different techniques with which you can find search terms that have low enough competition, like we need in order to rank our videos. And this way you can make it happen, make your SEO work. Cheers, my friends.